today on Fox News Live. From their fairy tale wedding to her very unhappy ending, get the inside story on Charles and Diana's stormy marriage. Plus, it's a cancer warning. Your food could be fatal. Find out why and how to protect yourself. Then, She's Hot, Hot, Hot. Survivor Jerry Manzi bears all for the pages of Playboy. That's today on Fox News Live. Tonight, a congressman under fire. Former Attorney General Ed Meese weighs in. Then, just who picked up the phone when Carolyn Condit called? That's tonight, only on the Fox News Channel.
Fox on top. A D.C. cop still combing Rock Creek Park inside the Beltway for any sign of Chandra Levy. Hi, everybody. I'm David Asman. Thanks for joining us. It's noon in the east, 9 o'clock out west. It's now 3 months since anybody saw Chandra Levy, and police are kicking off this week's search at Theodore Roosevelt Island. Fox News' David Schuster is on top of the story, live from D.C. Police Headquarters. David?
Well, David, police recruits have found a couple of items. They found some men's pants, a handbag, and a switchblade. They believe that these are items that belong to homeless people who live on Roosevelt Island. But just to make sure, they have called out the crime scene search unit to do an examination of that switchblade. Roosevelt Island is a small island between Georgetown and Rosslyn, Virginia, right in the middle of the Potomac River. It is accessible by footbridge only. It's an area that's popular with tourists and people who want to walk their dogs or go fishing in the calm waters of the Potomac, that particular section of the river. At night, the island is supposed to be closed, although there are some groups of homeless people who stay there. Police say they are running out of places to search for Chandra Levy in Washington, D.C., and that the physical search will be over by the end of the week. Meanwhile, police are shooting down a story put out by Fox News and the National Enquirer last week. It was an allegation that Gary Condit's wife may have had a five-minute phone call to Chandra Levy just before Mrs. Condit came to D.C. and Chandra Levy disappeared. Here is Deputy Chief Terry Gaynor.
Well, I'm not aware of that information, so to me that's a rumor. So we have no need to interview Mrs. Condit again. She did that when she was in Washington, and we're comfortable with that. Well, we do have phone records, and to my knowledge, they don't indicate any of these conversations that people keep talking about. Flurries of telephone calls, long telephone calls. I think that's been part of the rumor mill, and that's unfortunate.
Again, police have gone to great lengths to suggest that they have no reason to interview Gary Condit's wife again, and that they are still not calling the congressman a suspect. But again, the search continues for Chandra Levy. They have finished the search in Roosevelt Island. It will be heading to Whitehaven Park this afternoon. This is near Rock Creek Park. It's essentially just north of Georgetown and just south of the British Embassy. David?
All right, our David Schuster reporting in Washington. So the bottom line, D.C. police recruits are combing through a place called Theodore Roosevelt Island today. Some items were found, including a switchblade, but nobody's saying if it's related to the Chandra case. Time now to get a check of the day's headlines with our Todd Connor at the Fox News Desk. Hey, Todd.
Hey, David. Thank you very much, sir. And hello, everyone. A steam buildup may have caused an antique tractor to explode in an Ohio County fair. Four people were killed when the tractor blew up and another 50 are hurt. The sheriff says the accident is going to be tough to investigate because all of the town's steam engine experts were killed in the explosion. The fair has reopened today. A computer worm called Code Red is wiggling its way through the world's computers. It's expected to spread again tomorrow night. The worm is believed to have been infected or believed to have infected hundreds of thousands of Microsoft operating systems so far. It causes slowdowns and defaces websites with the words hacked by Chinese. Israel says an explosion that killed six Palestinians was a work accident. The Palestinians say it was a targeted attack. The six people killed belong to Yasser Arafat's Fatah movement. Meantime, Israeli forces did fire on Palestinian police headquarters today, wounding two officers. Israel says the headquarters was used for making weapons. Italy's Mount Etna volcano put on quite a show this morning, although the flow of lava seems to be slowing down a bit. Emergency crews are still building earth and rock dams to protect the tourist center. The lava from the latest eruption has been unpredictable, slowing down one day, then speeding up the next. Finally, if he's true to his word, you have 1 week left to catch the Lord of the Dance in person. Michael Flatley says this coming Sunday show in Dallas will be the last time he dances in public. Flatley is famous around the world for River Dance, Lord of the Dance, and his current show, Feet of Flame. Coming up, apes versus dinosaurs at the box office. We'll tell you who won at the bottom of the hour. But now more Fox News Live with David Asman.
Modesto, California. It's hometown to Chandra Levy, and it's also home base for the man in the center of the storm, Congressman Gary Condit. Fox News' Jonathan Sary joins us live from Modesto with the latest. Jonathan?
David, it has been exactly 3 months since Chandra Levy disappeared, and her parents are struggling to get by on their daily lives.
And just the things you normally do, like, you know, when you gotta shop and you gotta cook and clean, or it's not easy. You have to make yourself do everything. Make yourself try to think in terms of normalcy. And there's no normalcy, and there's no guidebook how to be in such a situation.
The Levys are offering a reward of more than $200,000 to anyone coming forward with information leading to the safe return of their daughter. But so far, the search for Chandra Levy has turned up no answers.
Nah, it's just the same old thing, you know, except the only thing is they haven't found anybody, so that's, you know, still gives us a little bit of hope.
The Levy case has now divided a community that once wholeheartedly supported Congressman Gary Condit. Over the weekend, a group of protesters demonstrated in front of the congressman's office demanding his resignation, while Condit's supporters staged a counter-demonstration. Right now, the future of the congressman's political career is uncertain. Many of his critics who once supported him for being what they considered to be a family man and a stand-up, honest guy are now questioning those qualities, questioning whether they ever existed. And many people say it's time for the congressman to go. We're live in Modesto, California. Jonathan Sary, Fox News.
All right, Jonathan Sary, thanks very much. And another politician who spent some time in the heat of controversy, former President Bill Clinton. Well, now he's moving on up to his new uptown offices in Harlem. Fox News correspondent Eric Shawn is there. Let's take a look. Hi, Eric.
Hello, David. A big welcome for Bill Clinton here in the heart of Harlem. We're on 125th Street, about a block down from where the former president will have his office. As you can see, about 1,000 people and more turned out for what will be a three-hour welcoming ceremony for the former president. That will include prayers and songs and speeches and, of course, the saxophone playing and jazz that Harlem, the largest African-American community in the nation, is known for. But despite all the enthusiasm, Harlem was the second choice for the former president. He had first wanted a high-rise, high-priced, expensive Midtown office next to Carnegie Hall that rented for $800,000 a year. But he basically was shamed out of renting that one after the controversy. So he settled on 125th Street. The price tag to taxpayers, roughly $350,000. Still the most expensive office space for a former president. But it does boast sweeping views of the New York skyline and office furniture that's been designed by the singer Madonna's brother. Despite the song and the dance here, not everyone is completely enthusiastic in their welcome. Some members of a group called the New Black Panther Party protested his presence.
What is your objection to his being here?
The message we're sending today is that all of Harlem does not welcome Bill Clinton. That there's a lot of Black Harlem that recognizes that gentrification is a serious problem. And gentrification, the displacing and the removal of Blacks, particularly of poor income, is a problem, and Bill Clinton represents that problem.
Well, those voices are very few, even though that group has been protesting now, at least until the music just started. But as for Mr. Clinton, those who know him say he is really looking forward to his new office. We spoke to the former White House Press Secretary Joe Lockhart, who visited us here a little earlier this morning, and he said the former president was just glad to get out of the den in Chappaqua.
I was with the president when he made this decision. He was down in Florida, and you could tell that he didn't expect the controversy over the first office. And when they came up with this idea for here, it made him so happy that, you know, I think, you know, nothing's ever not political, but this was a decision about what would make him happy. And I think he'd be very comfortable in this neighborhood.
the former president, expected to walk from the office building about a block from here down to this scene. We expect him within the hour. His first day of work, starting off with the rhythms and blues. We're live on West 125th Street in Harlem. Eric Shawn, Fox News. David, back to you.
All right. Certainly has a sense of style, but a lot of people question that style of Bill Clinton. And the question is thrown out to you now for InstaVote. Do you think Bill Clinton's style might get in the way of another run for office? Will he run again? That's the question. 1-866-FNC-POLL, the number 3627655. Let us know what you think. We'll give you the results with our own John Gibson. That's at 5 p.m. Eastern Time, about 5 hours from now. Well, it is no laughing matter at all for comedian Paula Poundstone. She's in front of a judge at a preliminary hearing. Poundstone charged with committing lewd acts against a child, also 4 counts of child endangerment. Our Juliet Huddy has the very latest now from the courthouse in Santa Monica.
Well, David, this is actually the day where the judge will set the date for the preliminary hearing. That's basically the time when both sides will lay out their cases, or at least the prosecution will lay out its case against Paula Poundstone. Just a few moments ago, actually about 45 minutes ago, she arrived here at the Santa Monica courthouse, flanked by her attorneys. She spent a few minutes greeting some of her supporters and some neighborhood folks, and then she headed inside, and that is where she's been, again, for the last 45 minutes. The comedian is charged with 3 counts of committing a lewd act on a child under the age of 14, as well as endangering other children. Alleged victims believed to be her own adopted and foster kids. And Poundstone pled not guilty to those charges back in June at her arraignment. In the meantime, though, the judge ordered her to stay away from 2 of those children, and he also prohibited her from being around any child unless that child's guardian or parent is around. Poundstone, of course, is the comedian famous for her wacky, wild suit and tie ensembles. Part of her shtick when she's on stage is her humorous reflections on single motherhood. She started training to be a foster parent when she was in her early 30s. She's 41 now. At the time of her arrest in June, she had 3 adopted children, including 1 with cerebral palsy, and 2 foster kids. And friends and neighbors, a lot of people that we spoke to here outside the courthouse, say she was a devoted mother. She was altruistic. But even her attorney admits that she does have some problems. Earlier this month, he confirmed that at the time of her arrest, she was in a Malibu treatment facility being treated for alcoholism. And he says her drinking problems clearly did have some bearing on these allegations, although he wouldn't elaborate any further. We're live in Santa Monica, California. I'm Juliet Huddy, Fox News.
All right, Juliet, thanks very much. And still ahead on this hour of Fox News Live, what questions would you like to ask Gary Condit? I'm sure you have some ideas. Well, a guy who worked both as a D.C. homicide detective and an FBI special agent has 5 questions he'd like to ask the congressman, and he's going to be along to tell you what they are coming straight up. Also, as you just heard, comedian Paula Poundstone is in court today for committing a lewd act, or being charged with committing a lewd act, and child endangerment. Her lawyer says alcoholism may have played a role, as you just heard Juliet say, but is that any excuse? Fox News legal editor Stan Goldman will brief us on the case. Also, this guy's played it all. Ben-Hur, Moses. Well, now he's going ape again. Remember, he was big in those movies back then. A true living legend. Actor Charlton Heston is going to be joining us live right here within the hour. Stay tuned. All right.
Plastic holds the promise of a better world, taking medicine to new heights and giving our lives greater comfort. It's in the packaging that protects us and a pacemaker to empower us, every day touching every generation. From the ambulance to the emergency room, it puts the answers in our hands and hope in our hearts. For a safer, more brilliant tomorrow, plastics make it possible.
Get out, you scum. X14 Soap Scum Plus foams away scum. Herbal Fresh X14. Scum hates it. Noses love it.
I don't have to vacuum to freshen my carpet. I've got Carpet Fresh and no vacuum. Foaming on, odors are gone. The carpet's freshened with no vacuuming. Carpet Fresh and no vacuum.
I'm Father Time, and I like things that last a really long time.
That's why it's 2,000 flushes for my throne. 2,000 flushes. We measure in months, not weeks.
Out here, I'm in command. So am I supposed to say, slow down, guys, I'm constipated? I don't think so. You try to eat right. Sometimes you can't. Harsh chemical laxatives, they can kick in whenever and wherever. Not an option. So I rely on doctor-recommended Metamucil. It's got 100% natural fiber. Works with my body, gently. Which is important to a sensitive guy like myself.
Metamucil, the doctor's natural choice for regularity.
I was just diagnosed with diabetes. My doctor told me how I could get what I need delivered to my house.
I don't have to fill out those confusing forms. They take care of all the insurance paperwork.
I just make a phone call, and the professional people at Diabetic Supply of America take care of everything.
My mom doesn't have to stand in line at the pharmacy anymore. She likes that.
I'm amazed I get all my supplies at no cost. How can you beat that?
We carry brand name products. Ordering diabetic supplies couldn't be easier. Call us today to see if you qualify.
It's great.
Our next guest pulls no punches, and he's in a position to know. Mike Chamberlain is a former D.C. homicide detective, and now he's a professor of criminal justice at North Carolina Central University. He says he's got five questions for Gary Condit. Mike, thanks for coming in. Appreciate it.
Hello, David.
Now, Mike, you've worked for the FBI, for the DEA, as well as the D.C. police force. Just a first question before we go into your questions. Who should be leading this investigation?
The D.C. police.
Really? Even though some people have said, look, they dropped the ball, they cut Condit too much slack, it should be FBI?
No, I believe it would be just a matter of jurisdiction. And right now, and I feel that from my experience in homicide, that those homicide detectives could do the job.
All right. And you've been to the FBI and the DEA as well, so you speak from experience. Let's go to the questions you would like to put to Gary Condit. This, I assume, is if he was wired to a lie detector test, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, the first question, how did Mrs. Condit and you see your marriage this past spring? Now, obviously, this couple has some problems. I mean, you can guess that from what he's admitted to. But is this just a fishing expedition for you?
Well, what it would be a purpose of developing a rapport, just getting Mr. Condit to talk with me, begin to, you know, get a feeling of him and find out about his truthfulness.
You think his lawyer would allow that to happen?
Well, that would be questionable.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's go on to the second one then. You say Chandra Levy and he. How did he perceive Mrs. Levy and his future together? What do you think about that one?
Yes. I was wondering how Miss Levy sees her future in regards to Mr. Condit.
Uh-huh.
In other words, what is the current future hold for Miss Levy?
And specifically, this is important because why?
In determining her mindset.
And this might give you some clue as to what she might have done on May 1st after she disappeared.
Exactly.
Has this kind of questioning ever helped? Has it been important in terms of finding somebody to know exactly what they were thinking before they disappeared?
Yes, it does.
Can you give us an example?
Yes, what you're trying to do is to find out, and it'll give you a direction of how that person was feeling.
But you have found people based on getting a good profile of what they were thinking right before they disappeared.
Yes, in other words, what was their mindset? What would have led them to the next step?
All right, now the third question, this really does seem like a fishing expedition. You ask, it's been alleged that you've had several extramarital relationships. Present a hypothetical, this is asking Gary Condit, a hypothetical where one would take a drastic action resulting in a mysterious disappearance. First of all, I can't imagine a lawyer ever allowing a question like this be asked, but if it happens, this, by the way, is a live picture of Chandra Levy's parents. If they speak to reporters, we'll take that. But what do you think you might get out of Gary Condit as a result of that kind of question?
Thank you, Mrs. Levy. I know this must be a very painful day. It's been 3 months since your daughter's disappearance.
Yeah.
Anything new today? Have you spoken to anybody back on the East Coast? Any new hope today?
Yeah, we've spoken to some people on the weekend, you know, and we've got hopefully.
We've always got faith and hope.
Yeah,
we're
keep that up, keep that going.
These
3 months or whatever, however long it takes, is discouraging. But we got hope from good people, and people were giving us a lot of hope and prayers and faith and help boost us up and. You know, hopefully some of the, they'll have some leads or tips that will help. I know they're working on it. The police are not really searching the woods, but they're still working on things. And the FBI, I know, is working hard.
When they talk about
the scaling back that will continue through this week. And then when Chief Ramsey talks about the 50-50 chance of the case being solved.
Yeah, well, it's just odds. Doesn't mean anything, really. It's just every individual person.
I went ahead and tried to contact Silverado Patrol, and I don't know if they got my email, but I did call them yesterday, and I know that they have a meeting on Tuesday night at Langley Air Force Base, and also that their national headquarters, which is in Alabama, and if they need to, you know, if they can help, I appreciate it. And I'm not giving up, but my heart aches, and our heart aches, and this is very hard. It's very hard. Every day is very hard, and we just want, if anyone's out there and has our daughter, please reconsider, let her go. Let her come home to us. Take care of her and bring her home.
Dr. Levy, I asked this question to your wife over the weekend. I'd like to ask the question to you in your words. Your son, Adam, how has your daughter's disappearance affected him?
Well, it's really hard on him. He's trying to function. He's staying around to comfort us, and it's just tough on him, but he has good faith, and he has, you know, faith that we'll find her and bring her back, so it helps keep us going.
The police are now saying, as of today, they came out publicly to say that Congressman Condit was not a central figure in this investigation, that they would not ask for another polygraph.
Uh-huh.
How do you feel about that?
Well, that's what they think, so.
Would you like to see them continue?
Well, I'd like to see them look at everything, you know. I don't know if they have. You know, certainly, doing things 12 weeks later, I'm not sure you can get the same facts you would have gotten early on. So.
Any questions that you would like to still see asked?
We just want continuous prayers.
Yeah.
And ask God in faith to bring her home. And as far as questions, we can't come up with anything right out publicly at this point. Okay.
Thank you.
Can you talk just for a moment about the support you're receiving? We do see a lot of neighbors and friends come over. You had a friend in town from Ohio over the weekend.
Yes.
Can you talk about that?
She's wonderful. She's a very good friend of mine, has a very big practice. She's a psychotherapist. We were like sisters. And without the support of my friends, both across the country and friends that are here, got together and had a barbecue and took our horses out and rode a little bit, and for a moment I had a sense of normalcy, but life isn't normal, as you know. We've had neighbors and friends in the neighborhood and across town that have been very supportive, and in times like this you really find what's important, and you know that your friendships are important, and it's the most important thing, along with your family and your health. Those are what really is important. Now this stuff is kind of
we gotta keep faith going too.
Yep.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
The parents of missing intern Chandra Levy, Daily Ritual, they usually come out. Dr. Levy, he's an oncologist, usually comes out to speak to reporters before he goes to work. It looks as though that's what he's doing today. He manages to keep his work scheduled. Perhaps that keeps his mind focused on something else, at least for a moment. We're back talking with Mike Chamberlain, former D.C. homicide detective and former FBI and DEA agent as well. Mike, you mentioned before that you think D.C. police should be heading up the investigation, but we had the police chief come out yesterday saying he thought there was a 50-50 chance of ever finding Chandra Levy, either dead or alive. Do you think it was wise for him to come out and say that?
Well, I will not take his position. In other words, he's in command, and I would respect his call.
Yeah, but why throw out a call? I mean, granted, he was asked the question, and maybe he would have been criticized if he said no comment. But don't you think, at least for the sake of the patients, until you wrap up everything you have going in this investigation, you leave it open. You don't put odds on the discovery of this human being.
Well, I believe that the detectives would not put odds on the human being. I believe that those detectives would work diligently. I had been assigned to an old case squad, and you can rest assured that the individuals working will devote everything towards the case.
Now, I have to question you again about something I asked at the beginning. You say that D.C. police deserve to be the lead investigator on this.
The main question, and this comes to the last question that you would ask Gary Condit if you were able to get him to take a lie detector test, which is essentially, what did Chandra Levy feel about her relationship with you the last time you and she were together? It's an important question. This is the answer to this question could have offered police a hot lead while the trail was still hot, but police didn't bother asking the congressman everything, even after they had some idea that he'd lied to them about his relationship with Chandra. Doesn't that show that they were kind of slow in the uptake?
It's difficult to come back and go back and to criticize them from, we'll say, Monday morning. I don't know their full questions that they had asked them. However, I know what I would try to do is my purpose would be to elicit the information.
But again, I mean, there was a lot of time there spent that while the trail was hot, you're an investigator, you work for the FBI, the DEA, you were on Homicide Squad. If you get that investigation really gearing up those first couple of hours, if not days, you have a much better chance of finding somebody than if the trail is cold, right?
Yes, sir. As soon as the time begins to expand, the possibilities diminish.
So the point is that there were, what, how many weeks between the time Chandra disappeared and the time that they actually went into Condit's apartment, for example, and questioned him again once they found out he'd had a relationship with Chandra? That's a long time that passed.
Yes, but you also need the jurisdiction to get into the apartment.
All right, well, we got to leave it at that. Mike Chamberlain, we thank you very much for coming. Appreciate you being here. Coming up in the next half hour of Fox News Live, hog farmers beefing up for a fight on taxes. We got a fair and balanced report on that. And then Paula Poundstone, we got the very latest on her legal problems. Also, we're going to be talking to one of the stars from the original Planet of the Apes, and he's also in the new Planet of the Apes, the one, the only, Charlton Heston. Switch sides this time. We're going to hear from the veteran actor, a living legend, right here live on Fox News Live.
Kids love Kraft Singles because 2 out of 3 don't get the recommended amount of calcium. And Singles are a good source. There's something about Kraft cheese.
Refinancing your mortgage may be easier than you think. Just log on to ditech.com or call 1-800-71-FIX. Today's low fixed rate with 0 points is only 6.990%. With interest rates lower, now may be a great time to get cash or use the equity in your home to consolidate bills. It's smart money from ditech.com. Apply online or call us at 1-800-71-FIX.
I've always been a fighter, and I don't like to lose. So when I found out I could lose up to 25% of my bone due to menopause, you bet I was going to fight back. I had a strong ally who prescribed Actonel, our weapon. Actonel can reverse bone loss and helps your bones become more fracture resistant. Only Actonel is proven to reduce spinal fractures in the very first year.
Actonel is a non-hormonal prescription medicine for postmenopausal women at risk for osteoporosis. You should not take Actonel if you have low blood calcium, severe kidney disease, or cannot sit or stand for 30 minutes. Follow dosing instructions carefully. Stop taking Actonel and tell your doctor if you experience difficult or painful swallowing, chest pain, or severe or continuing heartburn, as these may be signs of serious upper digestive problems. Find out if you're at risk for osteoporosis, then ask your doctor if Actonel is right for you.
By this time next year, you can have more fracture-resistant bones. Act now with Actonel.
Tonight, a congressman under fire. What came out of the latest grilling? Former Attorney General Ed Meese weighs in on Hannity and Combs. Then, Carolyn Condit's phone call to D.C. before the disappearance. Her husband wasn't there, but who was? The latest on The Edge with Paula Zahn. It's the most powerful primetime lineup in sight, only on the Fox News Channel. The search for Chandra. You found your number one source for the latest findings. Then, the D.C. disser strikes again. Bill Maher lets her rip. Tonight, only on the Fox News Channel.
Hello, everyone. I'm Todd Connor. About 36 families have been forced from their homes by a wildfire in Washington State. The fire near Chelan, Washington, has destroyed a house and two trailers. So far, it's just 10% contained. Fire crews are having more luck near Jackson, Wyoming. The 4,500-acre fire there is now 70% contained with the help of cooler weather and calmer winds. Well, flooding has folks heading for higher ground in West Virginia and along the Virginia-Tennessee border. At least two people drowned. More than 5 inches of rain soaked spots already flooded by storms earlier this month. The president's pick to run the FBI has Senate confirmation hearings today. Robert Mueller will be expected to outline his plans for reforming the agency. The FBI has had its problems recently, mishandling evidence in the Timothy McVeigh case, a spy scandal, and missing computers and weapons. The people of Vieques want the Navy to stop bombing now. The Puerto Rican island held a symbolic vote yesterday, and 68% say the Navy should stop its bombing exercises there. The vote has no legal force, but Puerto Rico's governor hopes it will have some influence on Washington. President Bush is standing by his plan to stop the bombing by 2003. And guerrilla warfare beats out the dinosaurs at the box office. The new Planet of the Apes movie hit it big its opening weekend. It made almost $70 million. That was more than enough to beat out Jurassic Park 3, America's Sweethearts, Legally Blonde, and The Score round out the top five. Speaking of apes, original ape fighter Charlton Heston joins us in a few minutes to talk about his evolutionary turn in the new version. But coming up next, Cashing In on Wall Street.
Investors catching their collective breath as the earnings season finally winds down. And taking a look back at some of those earnings reports, the numbers don't always tell the full story. Hello, everyone. I'm Terry Keenan with your Cashing In report. Looking down at the big board at the New York Stock Exchange, a quick peek at the mid-morning numbers shows the Dow under pressure but still off its worst levels of the session. As for the NASDAQ, it is trading just about break even. Not much cooking on the street today. We did get some pretty big news from General Electric, however. That company's financial arm, GE Capital, has agreed to buy the business lender, Heller Financial, for $5.3 billion in cash. That is the second largest deal in GE's history. Heller stock getting a huge lift this morning, up nearly 50% on that news. And Tommy Hilfiger shares up more than 5%, this on upbeat earnings. The fashion designer reporting first quarter profits that beat the street expectations, and the company says it expects to meet expectations for the coming fiscal year as well. Tommy Hilfiger's latest results right in fashion with most of the companies that have opened their books in the latest quarter. So far, nearly 400 of the S&P 500 companies have unveiled their bottom line. And if you look at the numbers, the picture seems pretty good. More than half have beat Wall Street estimates. About 30 have matched forecasts, and only 15% have come in below those calls. But the numbers don't tell the whole story. Many of those estimates were drastically lowered, and the outlook for the third quarter is already starting to look rather bleak. First Call expects overall earnings to come in 17% lower in the period compared with the year before. And that is much worse than the 6% decline that many analysts were looking for. And as we've been reporting, Harlem is getting a new member of its business community today. This is former President Bill Clinton moves into his Harlem office space. Well, how much did his new digs cost us? Taxpayers will be shelling out $250,000 a year for the 14th floor penthouse office. That doesn't include his utility bills. Well, Mr. Clinton shouldn't have any problem forking over cash at local restaurants and shops. A Clinton aide has told the Washington Post that the former president keeps $1 million in his personal checking account. And with $1 million in cash, Mr. Clinton might not need help with his investments, though he probably could put it to better use in that checking account. We are here for you as well. Be sure to join me this Saturday morning for the weekend edition of Cashing In. Will Lucent go bankrupt? Can the company make it? That's an issue that we will dissect. We will also answer your investment questions. You can send those to us at cash@foxnews.com.
If Clinton's got $1 million in a checking account, he needs to watch your show every Saturday.
Yeah,
he can send it an email.
He definitely needs some investment
advice.
Maybe
he does. Who knows? As a matter of fact, we're just seeing little pictures of his head peeking. Oh, there's Charlie Rangel. He's about to speak in Harlem, a big rally for the president. There's Charlie Rangel. He's going to be one of the speakers, as well as Charles Schumer. But I don't think Hillary's going to be there. Charles Schumer, of course, is the senior senator just by a couple of years ahead of Hillary. But old Charlie Rangel's been there for a very long time. The Korean War vet is very happy that President Clinton is coming in his territory. He represents Harlem, and there is President William Jefferson Clinton, former President of the United States, and I'm not sure who he's followed by, but he's got a lot of friends up there in Harlem. He was, as Terry just mentioned, about to take offices in Midtown Manhattan at a price of about four times what he's going to be spending in Harlem. But in Harlem, he's spending between 200 and 300,000, Terry?
About 250.
But you add in utilities, and you might be over 300,000. Still a lot less than the over 800,000 he was going to be spending in Midtown. But there is the president in his, looks like a George Bush blue tie, doesn't it?
Exactly.
It's interesting. All right, Charlie Rangel's going to be speaking. Charles Schumer, the senator from the state of New York, senior senator. And we are going to be taking this. Are we going to be sticking with this? I think we're going to listen in just for a minute to see how Harlem welcomes Bill. Let's listen. You know, for once, Bill Clinton is not only on time, he's early. We expected him actually in about 5 minutes. He actually showed up early. He's got a better track record after president than during president. There's going to be a lot of preliminary stuff before Bill Clinton speaks. We'll take his speech live as soon as it happens. But for now, we're going to move on. We'll go back to Bill Clinton once he starts speaking. Meanwhile, a battle over pork and taxes for once. Not about big spending in Congress. The government charging hog farmers on just about every sale they make. It's a good cause, or just keeping them from bringing home their own bacon. We report, you decide.
Dale Lesline does not have a choice. Every time he sells a hog, Lesline has to pay up.
The government is making us pay this tax against our will.
By law, all hog farmers must surrender 45 cents on every $100 they make.
That figures out to a little over $50 million a year or $100 a minute.
The money goes not to the government, but to the Pork Producers National Council.
There is an alternative to the ordinary.
The Pork Council is in charge of getting people to eat more pork.
Pork, the other white meat.
Putting together pork ad campaigns and doing pork research. But some small-time hog farmers charge the council is stealing their money, only really helping the big hog farms.
They are taking my money to put me out of business. I mean, because they've been promoting large, promoting bigger.
We represent everybody, whether it's a niche market or a large corporate producer. We represent them all.
To settle the dispute once and for all, the tax was put to a vote last September. Hog farmers nationwide shot down the tax by 1,500 votes.
We did everything they told us to do, and then when we won, they decided we didn't win.
You see, after the results were in, the Pork Council filed a lawsuit claiming the election was unfair.
The vote had an awful lot of problems with it. There were many flaws. In fact, there are nearly 4,000 more ballots than there were voters.
In a democracy, you get voted out, you're done. You know, you're through. That's what it's all about.
But while the controversy is penned up in federal court, the hog farmers must continue to pay. In Durango, Iowa, Steve Brown, Fox News.
And coming up straight ahead right here on Fox News, we're going to hear from our own legal about the troubles facing comedian Paula Poundstone. Also, Charlton Heston, he's going to be here live, an old and a new star of the Planet of the Apes. He's going to be gracing us with his presence. Bill McCuddy is going to be taking on Charlton Heston. That's all coming up right here on Fox.
What if every market operated like the stock market? Would price swings leave you paralyzed with indecision? Or would you chase whatever's hot at the moment? A Merrill Lynch financial advisor will help you develop a disciplined plan based on your risk tolerance and investment goals so you can become a smarter investor, not an impulsive one.
How many 1 liter bottles would you have to buy to equal the amount of water you get from one pure faucet mount? About 378. Pure faucet mount filters. Pure water made easy.
There's no other bar quite like it. The white stripes are a moisturizing cleanser. The pink stripes have a nourishing lotion with vitamin E. They work together to create Dove Nutrium. It nourishes your skin to a healthy, radiant glow.
Since people spend so much time in their SUVs, engineer Steve Karpowicz filled the all-new GMC Envoy with all the comforts of home. Like climate control with 25 degrees of separation, available digital Bose audio, and the convenience of OnStar. So whether you're enjoying a drive or just enjoying your driveway, Steve says there's no place like Envoy. Introducing the all-new GMC Envoy.
Your pet's exact same heartworm and flea medications delivered to your door for less than you're paying now.
It costs less than buying from my veterinarian.
Took less than 5 minutes to order.
You don't have to make an appointment. You don't have to miss work.
Now I call Pet Meds and get my pet's heartworm medication delivered right to my door.
The exact same flea and tick medications you get from your vet.
Only they're cheaper.
1-888-PET-MEDS. We deliver savings and convenience on HeartGuard, Advantage, Frontline, and all other pet medications. Call to order now or order online.
Well, as we mentioned earlier, comedian Paula Poundstone in front of a judge today. She's been accused of lewd acts with a child. Her lawyer says alcohol may be part of the problem, but is that an excuse? Fox News' legal editor Stan Goldman joins us now live from the courthouse. Stan, and if she shows up at any point, I guess we can go to that. But we just saw a picture of her lawyer who said something kind of interesting. Stephen Crone is an attorney for Paula Poundstone, and he was quoted earlier saying, "It's my belief that Paula's drinking problems clearly had a bearing on the allegations that led to her arrest." Now, what could that mean?
Well, I found it very surprising when he made a not unsimilar statement about a week ago saying that she was an alcohol treatment program. California does not allow someone to either get away with a crime or have their punishment mitigated simply by the fact that they were drunk, unless they were so drunk they completely lack any intent to commit the crime.
Let me just stop you there and say you actually can use getting drunk as an excuse for committing a crime?
You know, in California, it is possible if you were so drunk that you were at the level that scientists would say you were basically unconscious, unable to manifest any intent. But I got to tell you, you got to be real drunk for that. So clearly, he's not aiming this, unless she was incredibly drunk, at any kind of defense. But he might be aiming it at an attempt to make some sort of plea bargain, or perhaps to lessen the feelings the public might have towards her of ill will with respect to this event. But it's a very interesting thing to say, because it doesn't seem to be a statement, she's completely innocent, she didn't do anything, this is ridiculous, the child made a lot. That's not what we're hearing, although those sorts of statements might be precluded by the court order to talk about the substance of the case. But we are hearing is she was in an alcohol program, and this tends to lessen one's judgment. Well, why are we talking about judgment if, in fact, nothing happened?
Well, listen, you got to have some sympathy for alcoholics, but at the same time, you got to have a hell of a lot more sympathy for a child who has been abused in some way. I mean, essentially, there is some admission of guilt here. How much do you think we're actually going to see? Is it just going to be on the child endangerment charges, for which she's been charged four times, or that one really nasty count of lewd activity with a minor?
Well, you know, the judge sent Paula out for a pre-plea probation report. Try to say that 12 times. And what that means is the probation department will talk to her, will write up a report about her without discussing with her the facts of this case, in anticipation of the possibility that in some future proceeding she may very well plead guilty or work out some kind of plea bargain with the government. And a bargain that might not be unusual in a case like this with a first offender, especially if the conduct with the child is not particularly horrific, is to plead guilty to child endangerment, let's say. Now, I'm not saying that's going to happen, and I'm not saying she won't be completely acquitted and there's a complete denial here because she has pled not guilty. But it's very interesting, as you mentioned when we began, that he's already discussing the fact that she has this drinking problem, that her judgment was in some way impaired.
Yeah, but you know, trying to find a dividing line between really bad lewd behavior with a kid and bad lewd behavior, they actually do that? I mean, they
well,
slice,
you know,
that
this
definition?
This is a very broad statute. It can run the gamut from almost being anything such as what we would think of as child molestation to having the child present when some sort of conduct of a sexual nature, for example, is taking place.
that could be lewd conduct, even indecent exposure in front of a child could be lewd conduct, which is in some respects a far cry from, say, an actual sexual act upon the person of a child, and yet they're all potentially covered within this same statute, which is very broad in California, lewd conduct with a child.
Now, the fact that, her attorney has kind of tipped his hand, at least she hasn't admitted everything, but the fact that he said, look, whatever happened, it was the booze talking, or is the booze doing the act and not the person. I mean, what do you think we're going to hear? Are we going to hear some admissions of very frank admissions of guilt here? Are we going to hear this thing of, oh, it was all a haze, I don't remember anything?
Well, it's very hard to say what's going to happen. I mean, that does give us an odd hint, and I'm kind of surprised Steve Krohn, who I used to work with years ago as a lawyer, would make that statement unless there was a suggestion that perhaps that's the way the defense is going to go. A lot of people in cases like this, especially with a foster child like this of a certain age, might very well say the child has made this up because she's angry at her foster mother because the mother wouldn't let her do things. Perhaps she comes from a difficult background herself. Perhaps that would be a not atypical defense here, especially since we are dealing with a woman defendant, which is a very rare occurrence in the courts, that you find a woman charged with lewd conduct with a child. You know, 1 out of 100 cases. They almost always involve men, of course. So one would have thought that would have been the avenue of the defense, but as you point out, it's very interesting that the defense has chosen to tell us that her judgment may very well have been clouded by her alcohol abuse.
Yeah, that's for sure. We'll see. It might be a unique defense here. All right, Goldman and Santa Monica. Sure. Stan, thanks very much. We're watching for the president, the former president, Bill Clinton. He's about to speak. And meanwhile, going ape. We're not talking about Bill Clinton necessarily here. We're talking about Planet of the Apes. It's storming the box office once again. $69 million last weekend. I think that's the third largest gross ever. Well, the man who was in the old one, and he's in the new one. It's just a cameo, but he's there. Charlton Heston, one of the great legends of all time. He's going to be here live with our own Bill McCuddy, coming right up right here on Fox.
This program is brought to you by Fuji Photo Film, a leading provider of professional and broadcast audio and video recording products.
Freezing chicken? Only Ziploc double guard freezer bags have an inner layer that clings to seal out air that causes freezer burn. Regular freezer bags don't. Put an end to freezer burn with a Ziploc double guard freezer bag. Freezing steak? Only Ziploc double guard freezer bags have an inner layer that clings to seal out air that causes freezer burn. Regular freezer bags don't. Put an end to freezer burn with a Ziploc double guard freezer bag.
Out here, I'm in command. So am I supposed to say, slow down, guys, I'm constipated? I don't think so. You try to eat right. Sometimes you can't. Harsh chemical laxatives, they can kick in whenever and wherever. Not an option. So I rely on doctor-recommended Metamucil. It's got 100% natural fiber. Works with my body, gently, which is important to a sensitive guy like myself.
Metamucil, the doctor's natural choice for regularity.
Hi, Billy Mays here for OxyClean, the stain specialist. Powered by the air you breathe, activated by the water that you and I drink. It's Mother Nature approved, then it's safe on your colored fabrics.
OxyClean seeks out organic stains. It'll even take red wine and grape juice out of white carpeting. Make a paste, make it 10 times as powerful. It'll whiten your grout and get rid of your toughest stains. Soak your fabrics, even lace. It has the power of bleach without the damaging side effects of chlorine. Use it in your laundry. It'll make your whites whiter, your brights brighter. Call now and you'll receive a whopping 6-pound bucket of OxyClean for just $19.95. But if you call in the next 20 minutes, we'll also include a squirt bottle, a super chamois, and a bottle of our world-famous Orange Clean free. Here's how to order.
Call to order your 6-pound bucket of OxyClean for only $19.95. Call now and we'll include the super chamois, squirt bottle, and Orange Clean absolutely free. Call 1-800-429-3883. Call now.
Are you losing the battle of the bulge? Then you need the Abdur system, designed to aerobically burn fat as it flattens your abs in just minutes a day. Look, ab machines strengthen muscles but won't reduce your waist, and some exercises can make your muscles bigger. Only the Abdur's rotating torso trimmer targets your upper abs, lower abs, and obliques all in one fat-burning circular motion. You'll flatten your stomach in weeks, not months. We guarantee it.
Before I started using the Abdur system, I was very unhappy the way I looked. Ever since I started using the Abdur system, I started seeing immediate results. and I feel so much happier and more confident in everything I do.
These machines cost up to $8,000. The Abdur does the work of all these machines, and now it can be yours for six payments of only $29.95. But wait, call within the next 10 minutes and we'll make the last payment for you. Plus, you get the Abdovix nutritional guide and motivational video free. We guarantee you'll lose at least 2 inches in just 10 days or your money back. Order today.
Well, he starred in The Ten Commandments and played the hero in the original Planet of the Apes, but now it's role reversal for this living legend. Charlton Heston playing one of those damn dirty apes in the just-released Planet of the Apes, and Mr. Heston joins us now. Thanks. Hey, congratulations. You're in a number one movie again.
Yes, isn't that nice? Yeah.
Are you surprised?
I'm delighted. My accountants are delighted.
You got a piece of this one?
A little bit.
Oh, good for you. So even $70 million must seem like, you know, they were saying 50 to 60. Were you surprised that it opened as big as it did?
The first one opened hugely, too. I have no idea how they will turn out. Of course, the first one then spawned, I think, four sequels, which I thought that made the end of it. But when Dick Zanuck approached me about appearing in this one, I couldn't turn it down. It was a good chance to be in a picture I remember very well, and in the remake sequel. I'm so glad it turned out.
One of the biggest question marks about this one was how it could possibly live up to the last one in terms of the ending. Without giving the ending away to people who haven't seen it, do you think this one lives up to the original?
Yes, I think so. I think it does. It's a very clever idea, and it works for audiences. And any picture needs a good ending, of course. And both versions of this have good endings.
But boy, we're looking at a little bit of you in the original, and that very Twilight Zone-esque ending that Rod Serling, in fact, had a hand in, would seem almost impossible to top. Do you remember the first time you read it, seeing that last page, and what your thought was at the ending at that time?
No, of course, we hadn't worked out the ending when we started making the picture. And it was just a killing ending, just marvelous ending, one of the best endings for a movie I've ever seen.
And you think this one lives up to it?
I think so, yes, indeed, in a different way, obviously.
Listen, there is in this one sort of an anti-gun message, and that you're part of that in a way in the scene that you have with Tim Roth. How's that going to play with your NRA buddies?
I don't remember that. I remember in the first one, there was a thing where I said, "Do you have any guns?" And he says, "Yeah, but we don't need them." And I say, "Thanks a lot. I'll take one anyway."
Well, again, Mr. Heston, not without giving too much away, in this one, you make a little speech about guns, which seems sort of odd coming out of you. Was it something that
No, I play the alpha ape, and I'm dying. I spend my whole time in this picture dying. Actors love to do death scenes.
It is their favorite thing, but you give Tim Roth, your co-star there, a little bit of a warning. Again, I don't want to give too much of it away, but I thought it was sort of strange coming from you. You didn't feel the same way?
I've forgotten what's the line.
Not the line so much as that you show him a gun and warn him that this is something that
humans
will have. Mm-hmm. And I mean, come
absolutely.
On.
Absolutely. Well, it's accurate, isn't it?
Yeah. I guess so. You know, Tim Roth, did you two get along, the guy that you share most of that scene with?
Yeah, we just had the one scene together, of course, but I thought he was very good in it. And the main problem for anybody in this picture is to get the makeup on. The makeup took 4 hours to put on and over an hour to take off. Not my favorite experience.
You were completely unrecognizable, in fact, until you utter the voice, and then everyone erupts into applause, the two screenings I saw. You came to the premiere here in New York.
I did, indeed.
Was it a kick to see that for the first time with an audience?
Yes, of course. You always get a kick out of seeing a movie that you've worked in, and if the audience likes it, that's even better.
What about Mark Wahlberg saying he wouldn't wear a loincloth because he couldn't look as good as you?
I have no comment.
He really was scared. He told me he didn't know what part he was going to have, and he said to Tim Burton,
please don't make me wear the loincloth. I can't go barefoot and I can't wear the loincloth.
Well, that's okay. That, I think the never mind loincloth, I did my first nude scene in the first version where I'm being tried in the ape court.
Right.
And I remember I was standing there naked, and the coffee girl walked behind me with a tray of coffee cups, and she said, nice buns.
Oh, man. All right, thanks. Listen, we have a lot more technology today. Do you think that helps or hurts us tell science fiction stories?
I think you can do things you otherwise couldn't do. You know, there's an endless array of possibilities now, and that they didn't have. Really, the first version was the first space opera. This was before Lost in Space or any of them. And it's a different possibility. You can do different kinds of things.
Would you like to see another one in the series, or do you think they should quit now?
Not my choice. I'm an actor. If I get offered a part, maybe I'll do it again.
Charlton Heston, thank you so much. Again, congratulations on being in the number one movie of the weekend and continued success.
I love talking to you.
Okay, thanks. David, back to you.
He also loves Bill O'Reilly, from what I've heard, and from Charlton Heston to Bill Clinton. We're going to be talking about that in just a minute. Straight ahead in the next hour of Fox News Live. Over 3 months of investigations, still no answers in the Chandra Levy missing persons case. Well, now D.C. cops are saying they may be giving up on those park searches altogether. We're live with the very latest on that. And then we want some feedback from you. Is it time for the FBI to take over this investigation, take it away from the D.C. cops? A lot of criticism laid charged of the D.C. cops. Let us know what you think. 1-888-TELL-FOX, or you can email us, comments@foxnews.com. And President Clinton, right now, he is in Harlem. He is moving into his new digs today in New York's historic district. We're going to take you there live. He's just about to speak. We'll bring you there when he does. Also, why danger could be lurking in your backyard barbecue. All that coming right here in the most powerful name in news, Fox News Channel.
Since 1996, Peyto's Health Management Services has been working to enhance care for premature and fragile newborns and their families.
We focus on serving families whose infants are admitted to the NICU, namely the neonatal intensive care unit. We serve these families through contracts with insurers and health plans around the country who recognize the value that we bring to these families in this situation.
Peyto's has blazed an exciting new trail in the healthcare industry by being innovative in several ways. One is the vital link between family and their Peyto's care manager. These skilled professionals support and educate families through the NICU experience and follow up once their baby comes home.
Our care manager centers them and provides them with information that can make them feel more comfortable about the care that their baby is receiving.
Peyto's also works closely with neonatologists and NICU nurses, which is no easy feat considering the complex nature of the NICU.
Having the knowledge of what these babies go through, what the families go through, that makes us a unique company to help the doctors and nurses do their job.
Peyto's also brings clinicians together to set the standard for NICU care, and it maintains a database that compares NICU practices nationwide. The end results of these efforts are improved outcomes and healthier babies.
By using the techniques that Peyto's has developed, both in terms of its database, its application of management to newborn practices around the country, the outcomes are improved, parents are satisfied, and we have results that I think are second to none.
To find out more, call Peyto's at 1-800-396-0706.
I love sharing my passion for dance with children. Being a dance teacher really takes a toll on your skin, on your body.
Dove knows beautiful skin is healthy skin.
After a long day of dancing, my skin craves nourishment.
With stripes of cleanser and vitamin E lotion, Dove Nutrium replenishes essential nutrients and restores the radiance life takes away.
It's like it feeds my skin, it gives it nourishment. I try to stay physically fit and healthy because your body's your instrument. It makes your skin so soft.
Believe it or not,
it or not, that's a new dance craze before we finish up the hour. Could this dance craze be on its way to a gym near you, a workout like you have never seen before? Here's your first look at something I can call Marsala Bang Raw.
This is Bhangra, a Punjabi folk dance performed by men in India to celebrate the harvest. Now the traditional moves have made their way to the gyms of New York. The Marsala Bhangra workout was invented by Serena Jen. Masala means spice in Hindi. Born in Southern California, Serena turned to her roots to create the high-intensity cardio workout.
I've been in the fitness industry for the past 12 years, and I've always wanted to bring my own culture into the fitness industry. I just didn't know how. I didn't know how I was going to do it, I didn't know when, what. So I just basically strategized this entire plan of, okay, this is the move that I'm going to do here. These are the moves that I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to call it. This is what I'm going to teach it. And I just finally did it.
The Marsala Bhangra workout utilizes most major muscles in the body, but it's the use of the shoulders and hands that gives the heart-pounding workout an ethnic edge.
Both arms go open, call out to the music.
The classes are gaining steam with people who don't mind dancing to the beat of a new drum.
I love the music, and I love the steps, and I think it's the most amazing workout. Out of all the dance classes I've taken, this is an incredible workout.
I love that it's so high-paced. It's very rhythmic.
It's cross-cultural. There's elements of hip-hop, there's elements of reggae, incredible beat, and you'll see a lot of both men and women and from all different types of backgrounds in the class.
I have been to India and I've seen Bhangra done, you know, as it's supposed to be done, and this is the closest I've seen to it here, so it's amazing.
Kimberly Richardson, Fox 5 News.